so I'm just gonna put me over on the side here, be discreet in the public, cover it over with my internet page. I'm gonna watch YouTube videos, and if I decide to talk, I'll talk. I'm feeling kind of tired right now. Been using a lot of energy this week doing my radio program out in the backyard. Touching on some wonderful stuff, man. Basically, at the heart of it, it's this. The private military educational representative in the public on the internet, on YouTube, is Winston Shrout. And he has his own YouTube station called Winston Shrout. And if you listen to his latest video and his other videos, latest ones, he's mentioning get to know your neighbors. In other words, that's what his way of saying pass the word, the information to the public, to the neighbors, how to be able to move up the pyramid. And so that's basically what I've been doing. And basically I've been putting it like this. Winston Shrout is private military, and so am I. And I am the private military representative who brings information personally to the public. And the next day, reading some information, reading a book called Golden Flower, The Secret of the Golden Flower. It's a Chinese book. Just get this computer to work now. I got a spinning ball. See if I can fix this. Like they might have turned on the heater. Well, I can't get. The universe is not allowing me to bring my YouTube on. So I'm just going to keep it like this. Well, in order for me to be able to see if I can. It will allow me to. Okay. It will allow me to do my click on my movie thing, so we'll just go with that for now. But basically what I was saying, I was telling people on my live Tesla technology radio show out in the backyard that I do, that Winston's private public military top representative for the internet on YouTube for the public. And I am also a private international military. I've been undercover. I am undercover. I'm secret. And we are the private military, right? includes all the kings and kings, queens of the earth. We're all together in this, running the show. And the next day I'm reading my book, The Golden Flower. The Chinese to teach you about how to get in touch with your spirit. Only thing that this book doesn't teach you how to do is to live forever in this body. That's what I'm here for. I am the leading figure that the universe has chosen to bring everybody to the next level. I ain't gonna die. And it's gonna be before your eyes that I ain't gonna die. And I'm gonna bring as many people as I help as many people as I can with me to get in touch with the same energy that I can get in touch with, so that you won't die either. But it's up to you and how you can curtail your belief to believe it. But I am at the level of Jesus, Muhammad, and all these other figures, Gandhi, you name it. I am at that highest level status to bring the information to the people. But anyway, I was telling everybody in the radio program, said Winston's private military, and I'm private military, but I'm secret underground. He's with the public. And the next day, sure as shit, the universe and flew an F-14 Tomcat, the plane that top plane on my on the carrier Nimitz 68 CVN 68 that I ran the flight deck on. When I say I ran the flight deck, I'm not saying I was in command of the flight deck. I'm saying just my presence there alone made me ruler of that flight deck, of who I am. Although I was just a measly little enlisted E3 who made E4 before I got publicly discharged. Privately, I was still in. But anyway, the next day, the universe flew an F-14 Tomcat at top speed over the area where I'm at, coming from west coast, moving east. As soon as it passed my house, it headed north toward Washington State. Top speed, and it was so fucking loud. So fucking loud, people. That it confirmed to all the listeners that were tuned in to my speech in the backyard that sure as shit I was telling the solid fucking truth. But it was so loud, and I'm not one that's easily moved. It has to be something totally grand and great for me to be moved. It was so fucking loud to confirm my loudness in my radio show, because I was being loud in the backyard. Talking loud. The power just came up on me. If you've ever been to a holy roller church, they call it the anointing. And when you feel the anointing up on you, it is so fucking powerful, you can't hold back. You just let out. There's absolutely no fear when you're standing in the anointing. But, trying to get this thing to go here. But, I was, F-14 Tomcat flew right over the city, top speed, from west heading east, then headed north toward Washington. And it just confirmed everything I was saying on my private radio show. And, but anyway, it moved me. I'm not one that's easily moved, but it moved me to, it was so loud. That's what I'm talking about. It was so loud that, I screamed into the atmosphere. Ow! You know how you do at heavy metal concerts or whatever concert you go to. But the universe was just letting me know everything that's coming out of my mouth is true. And next day I'd even took it a step further and I said, I am the captain that's running the USS Earth. Because, and I'm serious, because I know who I am, the full confidence of who I am, and I don't shrug back. But I don't tell everybody this. I only tell it as I move to people that I'm feeling moved to tell. But like I said, I am at the Jesus level of honor to usher in a new beginning, a new level of shift. Mayan calendar shift. I didn't know who I was at first as I was going through it, but I come and I've grown to know who I am. I says, oh my fucking God. No wonder I'm calling myself I Am. Because I'm going to be the first one living on this earth for fucking ever in this same body. And it's going to usher in. In fact, this is what I said. I said, I am the Jesus who left, who started this stuff. One of the guys who started this stuff. Jesus ain't the only guy that gave the information. He's just one that's been mostly publicly recognized. But for some reason, he holds a great status. I'm still trying to figure that out, even in my education. As I keep school, getting myself educated. But I said, I am the Jesus that promised to return. And I said, this body is just a body that all the spirits of and souls of past lives are utilizing in a one massive generating full pack power punch to move humanity into the next level. And that's the level of balance and the shift being able to live forever in these bodies. I said those things. And it's all true. But it's up to you to find your own Jesus within you, because what I do, everyone can do. So that we walk side by side at the same level, capstone level. The same wisdom, same understanding, same knowledge. I just happen to be the first one chosen out of all the spirits and souls of past that are in the angelic realm awaiting for their new bodies. Because according to the Chinese book, they went too far the other way. When you go too spiritual, you disappear. The body dies. And once they died, they found themselves and said, oops, shit. I went too far. I was supposed to stay at balance in the middle so that I don't get born again and I don't die again. And anyway, that's who I am. I am the representative, the first one. It's going to usher in eternal life. I am the Jesus that left. I am the Joseph in the Bible. I am many spirits. I could name all kinds of people. The Moses, you name it. I am a power pack house punch. And the thing about it is I don't have to go into a trance like Abraham does. I am at the next level of spirit channeling. So I am in contact with my body also as with the things in the spiritual realm. So, this is all kind of new to me. All these revelations that are coming into me, realizing who I am. But that's part of the grand whole spirit. Is he's purposely forgot himself. And on a constant daily basis, he's constantly reminding himself and remembering who he was. He's recovering his memory. And he did it on purpose. When you start to study him out and understand the male and the female side of Father Cause and Mother Nature manifestation. So, as you can see, I'm kind of tripping over my words because, you know, this is the first time I'm bringing this on public YouTube for my 5 viewers that watch me. That's how underground secret this dude is. I only got 5 viewers, brothers and sisters. I know how to keep stuff underground, undercover, secret, under my control, so that the public don't riot. If I was to gather a whole bunch of millions of followers and all of a sudden come out with this information, you'd see all kinds of people rioting. But see, that's why I am the great I am. The spirit's talking now. Father Cause chose this body and the personality that I put in this body to bring this information this way. Because there's a collaboration between this body, this soul, and the spirit. Russell is my name. And Father Cause, the great I am, is who I am. Using this body. Just like Jesus, when he told everybody who I am, this is who I really am, a lot of people said, bullshit. And it's the same thing. You're always going to have your haters and your lovers. But you see, with the power of my causing thoughts, I'm going to bring everybody to a point of love. There ain't going to be no more hating no more. And so I have the gift to be able to minimize the effect of hazard and destruction, riot. Because I am the creator of all things, brothers. But anyway, this is how I've learned to talk on my radio programs now in my backyard. I tell everybody. Says I am the I am. I am the change. I don't sit around talking about it. I am making it happen. That's who I am. Now you're getting to know who you are, because you have the same potential. We all share equally in the reign of power. As of right now, I'm the first one. I'm the one ushering it in, because I'm the only one that can do it, and it can only be done by myself. Because I'm not dependent on no one. I have no friends. I talk to nobody. Nobody visits me. I don't visit them, except for my mother and my father. I honor my mother and my father only. Because I don't have to honor everybody else. There's a secret to honoring your mother and your father. And that's to be learned. But I visit nobody. Nobody visits me. I interrelate with no one. Although I say hi to people on the road and shit like that. I acknowledge them. Tip my head to them. And if there's some small talk. And maybe some deeper talk. For the most part, I am fully independent. I depend on no one. And that's the way we were all made to be. That's why I am the leading example. That's why this body has been chosen, because this body depends on no one and nothing. It leans in full trust of all supplies to be needed for this body to maintain. And that includes relationships. But you might see me tripping over my words and being kind of overemphasis and a little bit tight, and I do feel tense. That's because birthing something, it's painful. It's tense. But it is possible to give birth in a relaxed fashion. I heard once a story of a woman who didn't even know she was pregnant. And all of a sudden, something came out of her in the back of a taxi cab, and it was a living baby. She had no pain, no nothing. She didn't even know she was pregnant. Nothing is impossible. Everything is limitless. Anything you can think of, it can happen. And even if you're not thinking it, it can happen. Just because it happened doesn't mean it can't happen, because it's just proved itself that this happened, just like it did for that woman who didn't even know she was pregnant and she had no pain. The baby just came on out. Now you think to yourself, how would she know she's not pregnant? Well, a lot of people put on a lot of women put on weight and they don't know that they're pregnant. And all of a sudden they find out, whoa, damn, no wonder. See what I'm saying? But, yeah. So those of you that are listening to me, my whole 2 to 3 to 5 viewers, however long it is, you're very, 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 very much involved in what's really secret and underground and undercover that's going to be ready to unfold for the fullness of life for everyone. So you can just call me the Jesus that said he's going to return. I just chose this different body to return in. And there are, and you know, Russell and I am the body, the ego and the spirit together in balance. You know, are working on regaining the memory of all lives past that have lived, that are of significance and connected to this body. All the Akashic records are available. We can make movies on these lives, and because of the memory that's going to be fed, we'll be able to make actual Hollywood movies, acting characters of exactly what went down in history. Every man and woman, child. Yeah, it's all possible. That's why I say I am the great I am, because I am the limitless one of creation. That most people who are living in the body, when they hear such limitlessness being talked, they think they don't believe it. And doubt and unbelief is called the sin that will keep a man dying and being rebirthed and forgetting who he is, and then having to finally figure out who he is and recover his memory. Birthing information is kind of, you know, it's stressful. Once you go through a couple births, then it gets easier and easier and easier. And every once in a while it might be hard, but when I'm back in the backyard, man, with no limits, no restraints, because of my security agreement and lien, no one messes with me, man. No one does. Because they're all watching me, and they know how I conduct myself and behave myself, both in the private and the public. They trust me. They know I'm keeping my international peace treaty, and they also know that if I break my peace treaty, that I deserve to be disciplined, and that's where the corporation will step in. When you break your peace, they'll step in to help you, to remind you so you can get back on the horse again and ride again. But you have to be able to be real and honest with yourself and say, yeah, I broke my peace. And that's hard for people to do, because the ego wants to jump in there and says, no, I'm right. No, you're not right, because I created the corporation also. So it is me, the great I am, punishing you. Let you know, to get you back in balance. When you start to understand these things, brothers, you'll feel the life come into your blood, and you can have your share of the land to start from also, where no one messes with you. As long as you can do whatever you want on your private property, known as your own private sell. Till such time as you can branch out from that shell because of the population, popularity with the people, your influence. You become like a Benny Hinn. It slowly starts to grow and expand. You become a shaman. A shaman is a leader of leaders, a king of kings, not to rule over them, but to bring others to the same level so that you're kings walking side by side. That's what Jesus meant when he said king of kings. So, anyway, let me stop this one. I'm going to try to get my internet because I want to watch some YNT, man. Yesterday and tomorrow. That's the brute band of the 80s, YNT. So, love them. Love them dearly. In fact, I found out later in life they were from my hometown. I didn't even know it. Called the Bay Area. San Francisco Bay Area. My second hometown. My first hometown was Kansas. Merriam, Kansas. But I was born in Bellflower, California. And that's down in near Downey, Los Angeles. Los Angeles, California, where I'm from. I am a Mexican. And you didn't even know it. I am all things, brother. French, Italian, Indian, you name it. I am the I am. Okay, let me stop this and see if it took. I love you all. And I even speak in tongues. I understand there are all things, man. And I'm adding to my understanding, recovering my memory of my understanding. But me as the spiritual cause, the Father, I understand everything. If you can read body language and feel the intention,